Steele Hall was a politician for all seasons, considered dashing with trademark sideburns a sign of the times. Yet his premiership was short, just 2 years from the late 60s. He followed the Playford era and defeated Dunstan's Labor juggernaut.
People in South Australia are getting a little tired of the sort of Dunstan-Hall political battle.
Hall was often the unsung hero, credited with the festival centre site and Westlake's planning. His political courage is his real legacy. He changed the unfair voting power of country electorates, actually disadvantaging his own party.
But he was steadfast in his view that fairness and equity was something that was required in the political system.
That longevity of career and, I guess, degree of dynamism is something that Steele Hall deserves a lot of credit for.
The Libs lost government in 1970. Canberra was next, first sitting on the Senate benches, then he shifted to the House of Reps for 15 years. No one else has served as Premier and in three separate houses.
He carved out a place in history.
He's survived by wife Joan and family who've been offered a state funeral. Now, it's also a desperately sad night behind me here at Government House. State Governor Frances Adamson is tonight mourning the loss of her mother. Jennifer Cashmore died peacefully at home this morning, aged 86. She served in Parliament for 16 years and as a Health and Tourism Minister for three. She's perhaps best noted as a fierce supporter of palliative care laws and a true trailblazer when female politicians were in short supply. The Governor's now adjusting her busy schedule for the foreseeable future. And Will and Rosanna, I fondly remember both Steele Hall and Jennifer Cashmore in my younger days. As a reporter, they were both very polite and they were true luminaries.